You can find a lot of useful information on Google Finance on different stocks, mutual funds, indexes, and you can look at the most followed on Google stocks. And if you click on the stock, you can find more information such as the price, daily, 5 days, 6 months, year to date, 5 years, maximum, as well as some market cap and additional information. However, it's even better if you can track your portfolio or stocks you want to follow in Google Sheets by pulling the information from Google Finance. So I have a Google Sheets here and I listed some of the companies that are most followed on Google Finance, and I'm going to use the Google Finance formula, and you can click on the question mark to find out how you want to structure your formula. What does it require? So I'm going to reference now the ticker of the company, and I'm going to do absolute value for the row, but not column, because the column will be changing when I'm copying it over to the right. I can just, at this point, just close the parenthesis and enter, and I will get what? This is by default providing me the price. However, I want to get this information, which is price, high, low, volume, market cap, and all of these. These are called attributes. So if I want to change it when I'm copying it down, I have to specify it. So I'm going to go back to my formula, do comma, and I'm going to put a link to this first attribute, which is price, but then it will be changing all of them down. So now I want to do absolute value my column, because that will not change, but the row will be changing. Close parenthesis, press enter, and now I have suggested autofill, which I'm going to accept. This information is delayed about 20 minutes and is as of right now, so it's current data. I'll show you in a second how to get the historical information if you're interested in getting that as well. I have this information now for Google, and I want to have the same information for all the other stocks. I can just copy it over. Now let's just double check if this information is correct. Like, let's see for Tesla if the information being pulled is accurate. So I'm going to click on Tesla, and I can see it's 87.74, and right here is 87.72. I mean, there's a little bit of a delay, but otherwise it's correct. When you click on the formula, you can see that under ticker, it's specified not just to include the ticker, but also the exchange. So right now I just included the ticker. Google Finance, it's smart enough to pull the information on the big companies. However, the same company may have different stocks, preferred, ordinary. And the best way to make sure you're getting the accurate information, you're just not relying on Google to figure it out, is actually reference the exchange symbol. So I already did that. So I have the exchange for each of the stocks right here. And in my formula, what I would have to do is, when you look at the formula, it's asking you to put exchange column and then the ticker. So what I actually did, just to make it easier on myself, I also just did here a link between the ticker and exchange, so then I can quickly reference in my formula. So here, instead of referencing just the ticker, I'm going to reference row 4, which includes both. So I'm going to put row 4 right there, and now I'm going to copy it over. And nothing will be changing, because right now these are very large stocks. Google has no problem finding it, but it may be different for the smaller companies. So you want to make sure you get the most accurate information. Now, sometimes you don't want the current information. You want historical information for your stock or mutual funds. So let's say I'm interested in finding information on the open, close, high, low, and value for Google, let's say on September 7, 2012. So you can still use the Google Finance formula. So I'm going to select Google Finance, and I'm going to select learn more to have more information on the formula. I still have to still specify the exchange and ticker price. I'm going to reference it here with an absolute value, because it's not going to be changing when I copy it down. Now, what else do I need? I need to provide an attribute. So I'm going to link to the attribute on the left, which is open. Now, I also want to make sure it's absolute value for the column, but not the row. The row will be changing. Now, what else I need to provide? Because right now, if I just enter, close the parentheses, will just provide the current information. So I need to reference the date. So I'm going to reference the date, and it's not going to change, so it's going to be absolute value. Press enter, and here you go. It tells me that on September 7, 2012, this was the price, and I can copy it over, to get information on the high, low, volume, and so on. Additionally, I can also get all of this at once by referencing the attribute all. So I can just copy the formula right here, and you can see that it's providing me this information right there. But you can see that it's not really nicely provided, like especially here. I already have the date, so why is it showing me the date again? And then I already have the attribute open. So I just wish this information was right here, so I didn't have all this clutter of data. So there's a way to do it by just keeping this formula, but also wrapping it in index. So index formula, if you click on the question mark, what it does, it pulls specific data from the row and column that you specify. So I'm going to, right here, we have four different cells of data. So it's row second and column second. So I'm going to specify pull data from the second row and second column and enter. And now you see it's much cleaner, and I can copy this over to the other points that I retrieve. Now you can't do that with the all attribute, but you can do that with the single historical attributes right here. Now what about if you want to pull historical information not just for one day, but maybe for 10 years, the close or open of your stock? So you can do that with Google Finance as well. So I want to find out the 10 years of stock price for Google, and I'm going to do that between September 7, 2022, and then I'm going to subtract 10 years, do a formula here in case something changes, it will work, and it's 10 years, so it's two leap years right there. So now I have it between September 7, 2012 and September 7, 2022. Now I can still use the Google Finance formula. So I'm going to specify that. Now, what do we have to do? Always have to reference the exchange and the ticker first. Now, what else do I want? I want an attribute. So I'm going to say, I can either link it to a cell, or I can always say close, close price, like that. And now I want to specify the start date. So the start date will be September 7, 2012. So I'm referencing that. And what is the ending date? I'm going to specify September 7, 2022. Now, what you have to do is also, when you look at the formula help here, it asking you what's the interval. For the interval, you have two options, weekly or daily. So I want a weekly data, so I'm going to put quotation marks around weekly, because without it, it won't work. Close parenthesis and enter. And right here, it tells me for each of the dates, you can see it gives me the close price. I mean, you can format this into currency, because right now it just looks like numbers. I want to insert a chart that pulls that info by clicking shift, command, arrows down, and I'm going to go to insert chart. And this is like a default chart that's created, suggested chart, and I can just change the title and change the headings for my vertical and horizontal axis. And you can modify as however else you want, but it can tell you very quickly, and you can change these dates and the chart will be updating. So I'm going to say, let's say December 31st, 2021, 10 years, and you can see that the chart updates. So these are really useful things that you can do with Google Finance formula in Google Sheets. Like if you want to track some stocks, your own portfolio, and it will be updating every day if you just leave it there, and it's a quick reference and it pulls a lot of very useful information. So thanks so much for watching.